Welcome to this video with the new enhancements included in the March 2023 update of the Denodo Platform 8.0. In this video series, we'll be covering the most important enhancements added for the different Denodo servers and tools. In this specific video, we'll review the support to develop stored procedures using PL/VQL in the virtual data port. Let's start reviewing the enhancements of the virtual data port server. Now the users will be able to create stored procedures directly in the virtual data port server using the VQL without the use of Java. This feature also has some advantages over Java-based custom stored procedures. The SQL developers don't have to know Java to develop the stored procedures. They can simply use the VQL using this feature. There is no need for recompiling of a jar file to recreate the extension in the virtual data port server to save new changes to the Java class. Changes are made in the virtual data port server itself, and code for the stored procedure remain within the virtual data port visible to all developers/users with sufficient privileges. Please note that to use this feature, you need the bundle Denodo Enterprise or Denodo Enterprise Plus. Let's see a demonstration of this feature. In this example, we are going to create a stored procedure using the PL/VQL feature to display the Fibonacci series. We will see how to create a stored procedure in the Design Studio. Let us also see how to create a PL/VQL using the UI. After right-clicking on the database and navigating to New Stored Procedure, VQL Stored Procedure option, the configuration opens for a new stored procedure. In the Edit Configuration section, you can provide the body of the stored procedure. When creating a new stored procedure, you will find three main sections that must be filled. First of all, we must define the parameters of the stored procedure. Those parameters can be input parameters defined by in clause, output parameters defined by the out clause, or parameters that can be used as input or output defined with the in out clause. Then you can find the as section. In this section, you must define the different variables needed by the stored procedure. If you need to execute a query, you can create here a cursor that processes a select statement and stores in the cursor the results of that query. Finally, you can find the body of the stored procedure between the begin and end clauses. In this section, you must define the logic of your stored procedure. Please note that if you need it, you can also declare your own exceptions by using the exception clause. We have the code right here for generating the series. You can see the begin and end statements containing the entire calculator. Provide the name in the name section and select save to save the stored procedure. Let's create the stored procedure. We can see that the stored procedure is created successfully. Let's now open the stored procedure and inspect it. You can see that in the edit section, there is the body of the stored procedure that can be used to edit the stored procedure. On the VQL tab, you can find the VQL code that will create the stored procedure. You can also use this code to export the stored procedure creation. Now we can execute the stored procedure. We can see that the Fibonacci series is displayed for the first 11 numbers. In this new example, we are going to create a stored procedure that will query two tables with all the employees of a company and their job history. We will use those tables to show the seniority level of each employee. In this example, we are going to create the PL/VQL directly in the VQL shell. Our stored procedure will have four different output parameters. You can see the variables needed by the stored procedure. And also, a cursor is needed to execute a query to get the hire date of each employee and use that information to calculate the seniority. To do that, we will query the views BV_employees and BV_job_history. Finally, in the begin section, you can find the different commands that are executed to perform some operations of the data stored in the cursor and create the information that will be returned by the stored procedure. Let's create the stored procedure. You can see here the summary of our new stored procedure. Those parameters are the ones that we defined. In the VQL tab, you can see the code of your stored procedure, allowing you to export it in a VQL file. Let's execute the new stored procedure. You can see here the results of the execution of the stored procedure that we have created. Please note that the information returned in the column seniority was created in the stored procedure without using Java to process that information. Thanks for watching this video about new features for the virtual data port. If you want to learn more about the different enhancements added in the Denodo 8 March 2023 update, you can watch other videos in the series, or you can check the new features guide at the Denodo Platform 8.0 documentation.